If you have an app or a business or even a personal brand, then you'll know that content is king. Producing content for your blog, for YouTube, for social media websites and elsewhere allows you to reach more people. It allows you to build authority through the free advice and examples that you give so that people are more likely to buy from you. And today we're going to talk about how we can utilize the power of ChatGPT to help us create more content, and content that is specific to our audience. And the way we're going to do this is talk about a new idea that we have and how to create content for this idea using ChatGPT. So I'm going to show you the prompts that you can use in order to get the most out of this powerful AI tool. Now, if you're new here, or if you haven't done so already, then subscribe to the channel so that you can stay up to date with no-code tools and also AI. And also check out the description for our free guide to no-code tools and more information about the premium courses so that you can build something online with confidence. Okay, so let's jump into it. And I'm going to tell you the example that we have here, and then we'll go through the different prompts and some really cool ways that we can use ChatGPT to help us create content. So the first prompt I have here is to give a bit more information about what I'm doing, so then the ChatGPT model knows more about this. Now, you can delve deeper here and ask it to ask you questions, or the questions it needs to know, in order to formulate more specified responses, more specific responses for you. But we're just going to use a quick example here just to highlight the power of what it can do. So I talk about how I'm creating a soccer blog, and I want it to help me come up with new ideas, blog post head outlines, and blog posts through my prompts. The key is to create high quality blog posts. I want to attract soccer players who search for help with their game. I will be offering video courses on the website, and my goal is to attract soccer players who will buy these courses. So basically, I'm giving it a very general outline in terms of what I'm doing. And my goal here is to create online courses in the future. And you can build these using no-code tools. Just go to nocode.mba and search for those types of tools and courses. So ChatGPT responded and said, yes, I can help you with that. And I said, thank you. Let's focus on content first. Could you give me general topics to discuss on the blog? I'm looking for a general overview here to have different categories of topics. Nothing specific at the moment, but just categories. And I'm doing this because when you create content for a blog or for a YouTube channel or social media, then it's a good idea to have these specific topics in mind so that you can then drill down into the different topics later. It just allows you to think about this from a higher level, so then you have an idea about what type of content you're going to be creating. And I love what it comes up with here. It comes up with the general categories like technical skills, tactical knowledge, physical fitness and conditioning, psychological preparedness, goalkeeper training, rules and regulations, etc. And when you're reading this and doing this yourself, you'll get excited about some of these topics. And it's important to know that you don't have to just follow this blindly. Instead, you can use this as a guide to then go on and develop the blog or the content in the way that you want to create it. And then I like spreadsheets when it comes to content creation, so I asked it to put it in table format. You can see here it put it in a great table format. You can just simply copy and paste this into Google Sheets or into Excel. And then I said, thank you. Could you break down one topic, technical skills, into subcategories? So here what we're doing is we're taking technical skills and putting this into subcategories. So then we can really drill down into the different topics and subtopics that we can use to talk about on our blog. And it followed a response by putting it in table format again. So you can think about Google Sheets here and having sheet one, general overview, and then a breakdown of the topics in sheet number two. And then I went for it and said, now it's time to create 50 blog post ideas based on this subcategory. Now, I just wanted to reemphasize here that we're going for highly searched content, so we would like to focus on specific keywords. Could you create a table where you have the blog post title and also the search term that it is targeting? Now, at this point, it's important to know that we can introduce different tools here. We can introduce plugins as well for ChatGPT. But a tool that I like to use at this stage is Google Keyword Research, because most people use Google as their search engine. And by using the Google Keyword program, where it gives you the keyword ideas, it's going to show you how many people are searching for this, how competitive the keyword is, and also if there's been a change month on month or year on year. So you can use a combination of the two here to craft these blog post titles. And just to change this prompt, you might say, could you use your own capabilities to generate the keywords? But also, here is a list just to help you do this. And this is from Google. The more information you give, the better response you're going to get. So then here we have 50 blog post titles and the corresponding search terms. And we can see here, just to give some examples, 7 essential drills to master ball control in soccer. And the search term is soccer ball control drills. Now, these are obviously quite competitive keywords, and you might have to just go down into long tail keywords, which we're going to do in a second, in order to get picked up by search engines when your blog or your YouTube channel is fairly new. But here we have one subcategory, and then we have all of these blog posts, 50 blog post ideas. So you can see already just how powerful this could be in terms of generating ideas based on search terms. And the reason we're doing it on search terms is because we want to create content for the search engines in this example. So far we have general categories, subcategories, and then blog post ideas based on one of those subcategories. And then we want to break it down further by doing this. I said, thank you, that was what I was looking for. Could you break down the first one, 7 essential drills to master ball control in soccer, into a blog post outline? Include long tail keywords based on the general keyword that you provided, soccer ball control drills. So here, what we're doing is we're taking the main category, subcategory, blog post idea with the keyword, and then we're breaking it down into long tail keywords of that main keyword. And at the moment, I'm asking for an outline, just an outline of a blog post, not to write the blog post, but an outline. And it came up with this, where we have introduction, the components of ball control, the benefits of excellent ball control, juggling, passing, dribbling through cones, etc. And it goes on to the conclusion. And in each of these categories, it gives us a long tail keyword as well. Now, when it comes to blog post writing, I like to do two things with ChatGPT. Either create a blog post myself, write the blog post myself, and then ask it to edit the post, to introduce keywords, to introduce a style of writing, etc. Or to ask it to create the blog post and then I edit it. I'm going to look at an example of the latter here. So now, could you create a blog post on this? Write one that is authoritative, fun, engaging, and not too formal. Again, focus on targeting the keywords in the article. And what you can also do here is paste in some examples of your writing and ask ChatGPT to produce something in your style. But what we've done here is just allowed ChatGPT to create a blog post based on what we have asked for. And it started to write the introduction here, the next category components of ball control. When I'm reading through this, it's not the style I'm looking for. But you can say, please could you rewrite that, but instead make it a little bit more formal, or add in this type of style, or write in the style of this person. So you can see here what we've done is we've asked ChatGPT to come up with main categories of the topics, focusing on keywords that people search for in this topic, to then break down subcategories, to write blog post titles, to write blog post outlines with long tail keywords, and then even to write blog posts for us. And the key in all of this is the prompt and the information that you give it. So if you want it to be a bit more specific, then paste in more information or ask ChatGPT what it needs to know in order to make it specific to you. And then from there, once you've written the article, you can then use ChatGPT to repurpose that content into Twitter threads, into YouTube videos, into short form video ideas. And how much you use a tool like this is up to you and your creative process. So some people are going to use it completely through step 1 to step 10. Others are just going to use it to then dabble in for more ideas or to come up with outlines and then write it themselves. But you can see the power of using AI when it comes to creating content for your blog, for your business, or for your personal brand. Now, we hope you found this video useful. And before you go, check out a couple of other videos that we've made recently, where we created a website using ChatGPT. We also created a website using one single prompt. So check out those videos in the description or any other video on the channel that appeals to you. Be sure to like this video, share it with a friend, and subscribe if you are new here or if you haven't done so already. And then go to nocode.mba to learn more about how to create apps, websites, or anything using no-code tools and AI. Okay, I will speak to you soon. Bye-bye for now.